Well, hello. Today I decided to launch a series in the doctrines of the Christian faith. And so as you can see, the channel is evolving, and we're getting into new content. And I was in prayer recently, and I feel like Jesus kind of put it upon my heart to do some teachings, some talks, I guess maybe you could call them lectures, in doctrine, because we have loads of Bible study preaching type messages on this channel already. And what he revealed to me yesterday in prayer just astounded me with its vastness, but also with its simplicity. And so I felt like the next chance I get, I need to go ahead and make a video to share with you what I believe the Lord shared with me in prayer. And it's not often that you get a message from God like the one that I got quite recently. So, but I will say that all the other messages are how I would like to call politically incorrect. This one will not be. This one will be a different version of me, where I'm just simply teaching, and no sarcasm. Just straight up Bible teaching. And so the first message that we're going to be doing is going to be on God's omniscience. And what omniscience is basically is, I see you down there, camera. I'm choosing not to look into you. omniscience is a Greek word. Omni meaning all, and science meaning knowing. So what's funny about all this is that when I was in prayer, I was like, God, explain your pre-existence and the fact that you weren't created, and I couldn't get my mind around it. So God says, why don't I give you this one first? And he says, how about I explain to you my omniscience? And I'm not a quack. I'm probably, you would consider me to be a conservative Christian, although I'm moderate in some ways. This is a groundbreaking message, but it's something that a lot of people, theologians, professors, church leaders, already understand. We're not talking about revelation here. We're not talking about some end times thing when the stars are going to fall. We're talking about, how is God all-knowing? And break it down in the layman's terms to where anybody can understand it on eighth grade level. Okay. So in the military, that's what everything is taught on, is the eighth grade level. And it's kind of funny because it's kind of hard to concentrate on looking into the microphone because you want to look in the camera, but I don't want to look in the camera. So, yeah. Anyways, so it's pretty simple, really. It has several facets to it, but it's pretty simple. So basically, the way the Lord broke it down to me is this. Okay, how can God know everything? How can God know everything? And the truth be told is, it's quite easy, too easy for God to know everything. In fact, he could actually store a whole lot more in his mind than he'll even ever have to. Because you see, God is infinite. He has an infinite mind. He also has a heart. Also, he stores an infinite amount of information. So basically what the Lord did was he broke down several facets of his omniscience to me in earthly terms, to where people who say, is he really all-knowing? I don't know. Look, any believer who's been a believer for a couple of years, even people who aren't believers, God loves you too. He's not trying to exclude you from anything. You're the one who's excluding yourself. Okay. God knows everything that you're doing as an unbeliever, and he wants you to know that he loves you too. And that's why things happen for everybody. Generally, whenever we have prayer, we have three responses from God. We have yes, no, and wait. And, you know, only believers have the privilege of praying to God. Don't get me wrong. But God does see what unbelievers need, and he provides that for them too. It's called common grace. And the reason why it's called common is because it's available to everybody. So, but what you're going to see right here is me not being condescending, overbearing, sarcastic. I'm just going to explain what he showed me, and that's what all these messages are going to be about. So, my ministry background, I hold an MDiv from a very, very wonderful seminary in Wake Forest, North Carolina. Those are my credentials. So, I've been taught under numerous professors of the Bible through the Baptist denomination. But I think there are numerous Protestant denominations that are good churches with good pastors and people in their pews that are doing good things to serve the Lord. There are liberal ones. Probably the majority of them are liberal, but there is a remnant of good conservative Protestant churches in America and around the world. So, all right, you think about a cell phone. Think about the one that I have, this little flip phone job right here. There's the camera. See that? That's a little flip phone that I got right there, okay? It sends and receives texts, and it sends and receives calls. Okay. God explained to me that this is like our mind. Okay? Really? Yeah, really. This is like our mind. Simple compared to his. And God is the most advanced microcomputer out there that can do everything. Okay? So, God's brain has a whole lot more storage room than ours does. So, like I said, this isn't real complicated, but this is just a way to break it down to where people who struggle understand the scriptures, who are believers, can understand this better, and maybe even as an apologetic message to people who don't believe in Christ to say, you know what, maybe the God of that Bible is true, maybe he's real. I'm speaking from your point of view. My point of view is he is real, he is true. Okay, so, having said all that, the Bible says that God is omnipresent. And that'll be another lesson for another time, but in this particular message, God is everywhere. He sees everything. He is, let's put it this way. You imagine, let me think of an obscure country that nobody ever thinks about. Nairobi. Nairobi's in Kenya. Okay. Nairobi's in Kenya. Okay. And you're out in the middle of nowhere in some raggedy car driving around, and you see a gas station. And you pull into that gas station to get some gas, and you go inside to wash your hands and your face in the bathroom, in this raggedy, miserable, awful-looking bathroom. Do you know that God is right there in that bathroom? He is. His spirit is everywhere. That's what omnipresent means. God is right there with you in that bathroom. He's everywhere. Okay? He's outside of the walls of that place, and he's inside the walls of that place. He's inside the bathroom with you. He's not inside the walls, but he's inside the bathroom with you. Okay. His spirit fills everywhere where there is no matter, and it surrounds the matter everywhere. Okay. Now, when it comes to people, he actually passes through us. But in any event, so if God is everywhere, and it's been from the very beginning that he was everywhere when there was Adam and Eve, right? He was everywhere when Cain and Abel fought. He was everywhere when he was where the donkeys were staged night after night after. He's where the shepherds were in Jesus' time. God is everywhere. He has been around every human being and every living thing, and he's all throughout the universe. He's hovering around Saturn. He's hovering around Mars. He's hovering around the Andromeda galaxy, which is the nexus one to us. Okay, so he is everywhere. So I'll just explain half of his omniscience right there. He has been around every living thing, every nanosecond of the day, ever since he created man, and he sees and hears everything that we say and do. And he also knows our motivations, our emotions, and everything else. So, all of that is to bring us to this point. How can God store all that information, right? Well, it's really very simple. A lot of these storage devices hold an awful lot of information. And people live in age range from 80 down to a newborn baby. A lot of people live a long life, but a lot of people don't, you see. A lot of people don't. And so, you can go to average years, this and that. That's not really the point. The point is God told me, consider a football stadium. And you consider, look, you store how many papers when you're in college on a memory stick? Hundreds, right? You pull up that memory stick 2 years after you graduate from college. Are all those papers still there? Yes. Are all the letters in the right order? Yes. Have they been scrambled? No. All the papers are still there intact. That's nothing to God, right? That's nothing to Christ Jesus. What the deal is if you take a stadium, a football stadium, say the size of maybe Lincoln Financial Field, or even the AT&T Stadium that Jerry Jones built for the Cowboys to play in, and Redskins won, by the way, yesterday, just so the Cowboys fans out there know about it. But anyhow, Clinton Dix, your pack. How much information do you think you could store on a memory stick that could fill up an entire football stadium? Probably a lot, right? I conjecture that you would not even need a memory stick the size of a football stadium to hold every little thing that a person does throughout their life. You wouldn't even need a memory stick that big. Okay, so God asks me the next question. Is the universe large enough to hold every person that has ever lived from Adam till now? Absolutely. Of course it is. I mean, what? 10 to 15 billion people from Adam till now? That I think all the people that have ever lived could probably live pretty much within the span of the Earth, but then all the way up to the outer atmosphere, all out into space some, and probably wouldn't even reach Mars. Okay, so let's ask ourselves this question. A memory stick the size of a stadium probably would fit more than enough space to fit everything that God needs to remember about you. Now imagine you have a stadium for every person that's ever lived, billions of them. Well, you know what? How many suns does it take to fill up? How many suns does it take up to fill up the yellow star. What's the name of the yellow star? I can't think of it. The one that appears in the sky every night. Astartes or something like that. Anyway, the universe is vast and it's huge. And I conjecture to you that every person who has ever lived could have a memory stick the size of a football stadium. And you probably would fill up the whole earth with everybody who's ever lived from the surface of the earth all the way up to the outer atmosphere. And I just thought of it. It just popped into my head. What if we hollowed out the earth and filled up that with more football stadiums? What if we took the space between the earth and the moon, the whole radius all the way around? We would have more than enough space to fit the memory stick that God stores information on you your whole life. Okay? All right. Am I being mild? Yeah, I think so. All right. Just here to explain this. So, what do we mean here? And then God has additional storage space in his heart where when he judges us at the end, he will be able to discern legally and righteously your motivations and your attitude and your emotions when you did every little thing that you did in order to decide what your reward or what your punishment should be. Okay? So, the whole point of it, and I could stop this message right now. I have already said everything that needs to be said. God absolutely knows everything. And he is everywhere. And you know what? As believers, we are called on to live by faith and not by sight. I think that it probably takes more faith to not believe in God than it does to believe in God. And here's why. Faith is believing in something that you can't see. And that's a difficult thing to do. God, help us out with our faith. But to believe that God doesn't exist, and to believe in Islam or Buddhism or Jehovah's Witnesses, Mormonism, false religions, and to show that I'm being PC here with this, I'm not going to go any further than that. I've said enough. We are being kinder and gentler here with these messages. Okay. So, how many minutes has it been so far?
18.
Okay, good. It takes, let me tell you how much faith it should take you. It should take you more faith to not believe in the God of the Bible. You know why? Because at the end of the day, if you don't believe in Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, and I mean only him, Jesus says in the Gospel of John, chapter 14, verse 6, that I am the way singular, the truth singular, and the life singular, and no one cometh to the Father but by me. That means that you must know Jesus and no other gods. Okay. It's what we call monotheism. Another Greek word, which means belief in one mono god. Okay? So, if you live your whole life and never take a stand in your own heart that Jesus is the only way, all other ways lead to death and eternal damnation, you are saying that I'm going to take a risk. If I'm right and the Bible's wrong, and if I'm wrong, I'm going to spend eternity in hell. Well, you've got some guts. That's for sure. Because that just simply isn't true. I mean, the risk that you're taking is not smart and it's not wise. Okay, so I believe I've presented every little bit of information that God has given me on this. And as you can see, it's not whacked out. It's not some extraordinary Madonna vision or some angel appearing in a window. It is just that God revealed to me yesterday how he can be easily omniscient. And he is. And he says, get out there and explain it to other believers, anybody who will watch this video. And that's it. So let me close in prayer and let me ask God's blessing on this time. Heavenly Father, Lord Jesus Christ, Holy Spirit, we pray that you would please open up the minds and the hearts of everybody who hears this message. I pray that you would please help them to understand what is being said here so that believers can grow in their faith in Christ and their confidence in God's word, and unbelievers can come to faith in Christ. And I pray anybody who sees this message after Jesus comes back, what we call the rapture, that you would listen to this message and the other messages on this channel, the audio-only messages in this channel. There's a lot of Bible teaching on this channel called Pastor Sam that you can go through and look through and listen to get a very good grasp on what God's Word teaches. Go through each book with each video and hopefully come to faith in Christ once all the Christians disappear. Like that. All right. Amen, and have a good day, and thank you for joining me.